Ramnikant Pal from Madan Progressive School. Students, in my today's video, I'll explain you the poem The Dust of Snow, written by Robert Frost. Robert Frost was an American poet. The Dust of Snow is a very short and beautiful poem. In this poem, the poet conveys the message that how our view perceiving things brings changes in our mind and puts a greater impact in our lives. This poem, although is very short, but it has a great and deeper meaning. This poem also tells us that how the little things brings a positive change in our lives, and by these moments we can get rid of our day-to-day worries and problems. Students, now I'll explain the poem line by line.
Now I will tell you about the poet. Robert Lee Frost was born on 26 March 1874 in San Francisco, California. He was an American poet and known for his depiction of rural life of New England. His command of American colloquial speech and his realistic words portraying ordinary people in everyday situations. Nature is a dominant subject in his poetry. Central idea of the poem. It is a small and simple poem with a deep meaning. It expresses the significance of small things in changing one's attitude. The poem explains that the little things in life can make huge changes in our future. It also reflects that hard times in the life will lead to the happier times if we can persist with it. The poet also appreciated the beauty of the snowflakes, which changed his mood. Now I'll read the poem, The Way a Crow Shook Down on Me. The dust of snow from a hemlock tree has given my heart a change of mood and saved some part of a day I had rued. So student, this is the poem of two stanza. Each stanza consists of four lines. The new words in this poem, first is dust of snow, particles of snow, hemlock tree. It is a poisonous tree with the small white flowers, mood. A state of mind, rued, held in regret. Now I will explain you the poem. In the first stanza, the poet is talking about a winter's day. When all the tea drops were covered with snowflakes, the poet was in melancholic mood as he was walking by a wooded area full of hemlock trees. In this stanza, the hemlock tree and the crow are signifier of sadness and gloom, just like the poet's mood. As the crow is commonly the symbol of death, similarly the hemlock tree is usually associated with poison and toxicity. In other words, we can also say that poet was unhappy due to some reason. Might be he was facing some difficult phase in his life, or he wanted to kill himself. As it was not clearly described in the poem, students, as we know, it is believed that if a black cat crosses one's path, it leads to negative things that happen in life. Similarly, the poet has mentioned those inauspicious things like crow, hemlock tree, and dust to describe the negativity in poet's life. The poet was standing under the hemlock tree. Suddenly, a crow alighted on a branch of the tree and shook it. Because of the sudden movement, the snowflakes or fine particles of snow fell on the poet. The snowflakes were so light and seemed like dust of white snow. When the soft and cold snow fell on the poet, it changed his mood from the state of sadness to happiness. He started feeling soothed and refreshed. This simple incident helped him enjoy the remaining part of the day. He thus became happy, as it saved his rest of the day from being wasted and held in regret. The poet wants to say that the creatures or the things which are linked or associated with negative aspects of life, such as crow, can also be the harbinger of change and happiness. He also tells us if we have little positivity in our life or in our mind, we can find positivity in every little things. Similarly, the crow brings happiness in poet's life. I hope you understood the poem. Now I will tell you the poetic devices used in the poem. So the student, what is poetic device? Poetic devices are a form of literary devices used in poems. These are essential tools that poet uses to create rhythm, enhance a poem's meaning, or intensify a mood or feeling. Now the first poetic device used in this poem is alliteration, the repetition of the same constant sound at the beginning of the words that are close to each other. Has given my heart. Here H sound is repeating again. Same and same in the second line. And saved some part. Here S sound is repeating in the beginning of the word. The second poetic device in this poem is rhyming scheme. Rhyme scheme. Students, I'll tell you what is rhyme scheme. Rhyme scheme is the pattern of rhyme that comes at the end of each line in poetry. So here in the first stanza, the way a crow shook down on me, the dust of snow from a hemlock tree. See, the first line is rhyming with the second line. Crow is rhyming with the snow, me is rhyming with tree. Same here in the second stanza, the heart is rhyming with part and mood is rhyming with rude. The next poetic device is enjambment. Enjambment means when the same sentence continues to the next line without the use of any punctuation mark. Like see, you can see from here, there is no any punctuation mark in the entire poem. So this is called enjambment poetic device. The next poetic device is assonance. The repetition of vowel throughout the line is called assonance. Shook down on me. Here in the sentence, O sound is prominent. So, this is assonance. The next poetic device is symbolism. The use of symbols to signify ideas and qualities. In other words, we can say when the poet wants to suggest a certain mood or emotions and any subject idea. So, here in the poem, the way a crow shook down on me, the dust of snow from a hemlock tree. Student, the poet has used crow as a symbol of ill omen or sorrow and snow as a symbol of joy and purity, hemlock tree as a symbol of death. Through this poem, the poet has given a message to the reader to find positivity in the negative things, noticing and appreciating all the small things in life will make your life happier.